Jacqueline Deval is next to me. Glad to
see
you.
Very nice to meet you.
Glad to have you here. You work for the Hearst Corporation. It's a right. large media conglomeration, and you're an advisory scout for Hearst Lab. What do you exactly do there?
So I'm really excited to tell you about Hearst Lab. It's a division at Hearst that was founded about 2.5 years ago, and it invests in women-led startups. And so these are companies that are at seed stage, sometimes just family and friends funding level. And so they come into Hearst, literally physically come into Hearst. We give them space in the Hearst Tower in our New York offices, and also now in Amsterdam, where we've just opened an office a couple of months ago. And we help the startups grow. So the startups are in any of the fields that align with Hearst's 360 businesses. So that's often wellness, health, data, security, even beauty, because Hearst is invested in a lot of beauty content, and so that aligns with our businesses too, and service businesses. In the technology space, Hearst is a global media and technology company, and we help them grow.
And you also decided to invest in women founders, right?
That's right, yeah. For us, this seemed like a clear white space in the marketplace because, unfortunately, for women who are trying to start companies, their access to capital is so much less than that of men, like significantly less. And so we knew that there was a lot of talent, that if we were making prudent investment decisions, that there was a lot of value to be unlocked there. And, you know, and this is despite the data that shows that companies that have a woman as part of the founding team actually are more profitable and make more money, and they're also more conservative about their use of resources. And so for all those reasons, we knew this would be a great space for us. And so this was part of our mission for the companies, but also for Hearst internally as well, because the people involved at Hearst in helping scout and vet the companies that come in are largely women around the company. It's a big networking opportunity internally. Hearst is a massive organization with many divisions, and so it's really opened those connections up for women in the company. Mm-hmm. And we've also shown that women who are involved with Hearst Lab, and it's on a voluntary basis, this is outside our normal day jobs, but women in that cohort, there's a 67% increase in employee retention at wow. Hearst, and also a significant number of promotions. So it's a benefit not only for women-led startups and the women of those startups getting access to capital and expertise, but also to the careers of women internally at Hearst.
What are the most interesting business cases you scouted?
Oh, well, we've invested now in 23 businesses with a current market valuation of $400 million, which is exciting for us because we've proved success. So they're all wonderful, and we all kind of view them as like our babies. We love these businesses and the founders. We love working with them. I think a couple of standouts for me, one is Free Will. This is a company that came out of Stanford University last year, founded by two people while they were still studying there. And this is a platform with a beautiful, easy interface for users to create their own will at no charge. But what it also does in the process of setting up your will, you also can name companies that and favorite nonprofits to which one day you would like to bequeath, you know, some of your possessions and money and estate. And so their business model is subscription-based to nonprofits who want to identify potential donor targets during their lifetime. And so, you know, they're already running on a cash basis and are profitable. And it's an amazing success story, but really interesting how they've leveraged, you know, free customer service with a real business model that helps the nonprofit sector of the market. So that would be one. There's another called Wealthy, which is a personal dashboard for managing all your health needs. So in the United States, healthcare is very complicated, very expensive, very fractured across different payees, and very hard to manage. And when you have a family member who's in some kind of health crisis, you know, you're struggling to understand, you know, as a first-time carer, let's say for aging parents, or for if there's, you know, someone with cancer in your family, that, you know, those are real challenging issues to deal with. And so this dashboard is behind that is a team of social workers that help you manage all those issues, whether it's troubleshooting payments on your insurance or finding hospice care for a family member. So where Hearst made a difference with that company was helping them pivot from reaching out to consumers as an individual benefit to thinking more on the enterprise level and becoming a benefit that an HR division of a larger corporation could offer to its employees. So Hearst became their first big client in that way. In a way, they got to practice that with Hearst and perfect that model, and now are going out to the wider marketplace and have onboarded several clients, and Hearst has also taken a larger stake in that company.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
What are the benefits of working together with startups?
There's a lot that accrue to us as individuals all the time, every day. It's a little bit unmeasurable and intangible, but it's always there and extremely helpful. And so for myself, you know, as I've been thinking about my own book publishing and bookazine publishing businesses, you know, I've had some ideas about how I want to do things differently or to implement a new way of doing something or coming up with a different business model. And I find that in the way that, you know, the scouts and advisory board are there for the lab companies to help them, they're also there to help us. And so, you know, observing how when they're testing an idea, that these companies reach out very broadly to, you know, solicit opinions and advice and take that on board, that I found that, you know, adopting that practice myself was extremely helpful, and having teams of people with different expertise available to me like instantly has been very beneficial.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks for the insights.
Thanks for having me.